And the Lakers had one of the feel-good stories of the season when they called up Andre Ingram from the G League. He's been with the South Bay Lakers all season and had a special moment yesterday.
I'm excited about this. I'm happy for you. I know you're taking advantage of this situation and this opportunity. But I'll give you a call in a couple minutes. I just need to go over some logistics for the next 2 minutes. I'll let you celebrate with the guys for a bit.
Thank
That was one of the coolest stories at the very tail end of last season. A guy who's been in the G League or the D League previously for a decade, getting a shot in the NBA and lighting it up. If you remember, hit a bunch of threes in the first half of his first ever NBA game. Now getting another shot with the Lakers.
It's a dude, man. I'm a hooper, man. No need to get a real job, man. I'm going to play basketball as long as I can. I love the game. Glad to see him get another opportunity because last year it was amazing to see him in an NBA game at 32. Didn't think that we'd be hearing the same story.
And if people don't remember the story, he had the opportunity to go over Europe multiple times and make more money, but his dream was to always play in an NBA game, so he stayed in the D League then the G League at way, way less money to keep the dream alive. Got to play last year, going to get to play this year.
As good as that is, like the teammates reacting and being happy for him just makes it
easy. Yeah, I mean, everyone on that team's 23 or younger thereabouts, except for him.
What up, Pops?
Mm-hmm.
Time for stories to start your morning. Fisticuffs in the Raptors-Cavs game. Serge Ibaka and Marquese Chris exchanged blows. Nick, what was your reaction to this?
Man, I want to know what Marquese Chris said and why he was acting crazy, because there's a lot of people you might want problems with in the NBA. See, you say all the time, NBA's got a lot of fake tough guys. Serge Ibaka is not one of them. He's got a track record of throwing hands in this league. He almost knocked Marcus Chris's head off right there. He's going to get like 5 games. But this was a real NBA fight. I'm going to put you in a chokehold, and then I'm going to swing on you.
Yeah, he definitely said something to him because Serge got up off the ground meaning business. So don't like to see guys fighting. Not a good example. Lights in. But every once in a while, it just gets a little hot.
A little hot, man. Serge was ready to throw.
All right. Big news this morning, the Jets will reportedly sign 4-time Pro Bowl linebacker C.J. Mosley to a 5-year, $85 million deal with $51 million of those dollars guaranteed. See, you like this for the Jets?
Yeah, man, I had to pause there too. I was like, woo, man, the Jets, I was wondering how they're going to spend that money, but they got one of the best free agents out there. I love C.J. Mosley since he played at Alabama and ran those defenses, led them to national championships, led one of the best defenses, and one of the most complex defenses in the Baltimore Ravens the last several years. Great locker room guy, great leader, can blitz the quarterback on third down, can cover running backs out of the backfield. Jets fans, you should be happy what you're getting.
And 6 hours ago, before we knew they'd gotten C.J. Mosley, you thought the Jets had made one of the best deals of free agency already with Anthony Barr, right?
Yes, because the versatility, especially playing a 34 defense, he can play all four of those linebacker spots. Yeah, he's a phenomenal athlete.
So now you've got a legit pass rusher, outside linebacker, Anthony Barr, maybe the best inside linebacker in football, or certainly one of the best. That's how the Jets are trying to build it. Yeah, you got to pay a premium, but the Ravens wanted to keep him. They just couldn't match the dollars. This is a free agency move where you're paying at the top of the market, but you're getting a player at the top of his position. So I don't mind it at all. I like this move by the Jets.
All right, finally, Nick Foles is a backup no longer, officially getting his own team and his own big payday. Foles will quarterback the Jacksonville Jaguars next season. He'll reportedly sign a 4-year, $88 million deal with up to $50 million guaranteed. Wasn't a huge bidding war for Foles, but Jacksonville certainly paid him like there was, and that means the end of the Blake Bortles era in Jacksonville. CeCe, what'd you make of this deal?
Yeah, I don't believe you have to have a bidding war in the NFL. You've seen other guys, not top-flight quarterbacks, be able to get $20 million. Case Keenum, I'm sure that Nick Foles has a better resume than him. He was able to get money. Forget Mike Glennon. He was able to get a bunch of money. Sam Bradford, when he wasn't hurt, he was able to ink a couple deals making $20 million. So no, I'm not surprised at all. They got a guy that won a Super Bowl. He has proven that he is a starter. He took Philly to the playoffs again this year. If they get one other catch from Alshon in that game, we don't know what they're going to do in that game with the Saints there. So Nick has proven himself, and he's also got someone in the building in DeFilippo, who's their offensive coordinator, who was in Philadelphia when they won the Super Bowl. So that right there, given Tom Coughlin his interest in the NFC East, understanding Nick Foles, having that intel. No, I think it's a great fit for Nick Foles, and I believe it's a good price to be able to get a quarterback like Nick Foles at.
You obviously had to move on from Blake Bortles. The team, if you think the defense is still good enough to compete at championship levels, you couldn't have that anchor around your neck any longer. And just it seemed like the team, the defense, midway through the season, I don't want to say they quit, but they lost some almost motivation because of how bad the offense had been. So I get that part of it. Where you're in a tough spot is because you just this time last year committed to Blake Bortles, moving on from him. Over the next 2 years, it's $16 million a year cap space for him not to be there. Nick Foles going to be $22 million on average per year. So we're talking about the Jacksonville Jaguars for Foles and Bortles. That's $30 million of cap space each of the next 2 years. That's top of the market quarterback money. So you did upgrade at quarterback. I think I do believe in this instance, they did overpay at least slightly because I don't know that there was another team in the league that was going to offer him $15 million because we've got 12 quarterbacks drafted in the last 4 years in the first round that the teams believe in. The older quarterbacks are not retiring except for Peyton Manning. So you just don't have a situation where a lot of teams think, I'm going to go, we need a quarterback, even though obviously a lot of teams need a quarterback. Can you compete if you're the Jacksonville Jaguars at the highest level when you have a relatively speaking expensive quarterback room when you incorporate Bortles dead money and you're not going to be getting great quarterback play? That's the question. And the other aspect is for Nick Foles is, to me, his biggest asset is we know in big spots the moment won't be too big for him.
Right. He's only played in big spots.
Well, seemingly. In the last couple of years. Right. Are the Jaguars going to be in one of those big spots? Like we were talking about this before the show, about whether or not they can compete in the AFC South. If you get to the playoffs, or if you're competing for the playoffs, then knowing that the playoffs aren't going to be too big for Nick Foles makes him more valuable than your typical.
Well, the spot Nick Foles was in last year was not a big spot from a positive standpoint. He had to play great football to get them in the playoff hunt. Like, they were struggling. They were on the board to be able to miss the playoffs. So it's not just the playoff games. His play got them into the playoffs. So to say a player, oh, man, a guy plays well in big games and everything, to think that he can't put that together during the regular season, that's why you got him signed. And he was their best option. You can't have Blake Bortles as your quarterback anymore and send any type of positive vibe to your locker room or to your fan base.
And also he's reunited with John DeFilippo, who he played with and was his quarterback coach in Philly, so maybe that sort of eases the transition process for him. All right, let's move on to Le'Veon Bell, former Steeler, future, well, who knows, eager to get back on the field, though, that we do know. He is eager that after sitting out this past season, after refusing to sign his franchise tender, according to reports, the Jets are the clear favorite to sign Lev Bell. Bell isn't sure where he's headed, though, tweeting this out yesterday, I'm so torn right now. Decisions. See, the Jets, the best fit for Le'Veon Bell?
I don't know about the best fit. I think the best fit's Indianapolis. I believe because they're quarterback, given that Luck is back at a level that we are shocked that he's back at, their offensive line, the salary cap dollars they have available. I think he's a better fit in that offense and what they're trying to do than with the Jets. He'd be a good fit with the Jets, but the best fit for me would be play with Andrew Luck.
I think Andrew Luck and the Colts, there are two best options to me pretty obviously. They're both in the AFC South. The Houston Texans, which we talked about yesterday, and the Indianapolis Colts. They both have a ton of money. They both have a quarterback that you 100% believe in, and they both have struggled in the entire era of the head coach for the Texans and in Luck's really entire career to have a consistent rushing attack. The Colts in the last 5 years have not ranked higher than 20th in the NFL in rushing. The Texans have gone somewhere between 8th to 15th, and that's with getting the last couple years rushing yards or last year from their quarterback. They drafted Alfred Blue. It didn't work out. They signed Lamar Miller. That hasn't worked out. Now, I understand for the Texans, people are going to say, you need to spend more money on the offensive line. You need to go. Man, I looked at the offensive linemen that were signing yesterday. There are not enough offensive linemen to go around in the league right now. If you want to upgrade your offensive line, you're going to have to do that through the draft. So I think Le'Veon has made it clear he's going to go where the money is. And I do not begrudge him that at all. This is going to be, I would imagine, his last real contract in the NFL, if not his last contract whatsoever. I think the Colts and the Texans would be foolish to not discuss heavily, should we make the best offer for Le'Veon Bell? Both those teams, I think, feel like they can compete for a championship next season. And on the offensive side of the ball, their running game has been the weakest part of their game. Texans probably pass protection, but I don't know how they're going to upgrade it where we're seeing what Trent Brown's getting. We're seeing what the other offensive tackles have already gotten on the market.
Is there any concern whatsoever that he did sit out a year, that maybe he does have that, you know, couple strikes against him with the drug policy, that there are a few sort of negative marks on him? Could that possibly be?
Well, all players have negative marks as far as what they can do. That's the reality. They have a foul on him. That's what it's going to say in the foul. He's had a positive drug test. He's in the drug program, and that's a part of it. I don't think sitting out is going to help him or hurt him.
Okay.
He should have played football last year, in my book. That $14 million, that's money he will never get. I don't care what this contract is. Can I get all this money?
Yeah, I think the contract he's looking at is going to be about 4 years, $65 million, with probably around $35 million guaranteed. The first 2 years guaranteed plus a little extra is, I think, what he's looking for, and I think what he can expect. Now, on the Jets side of things, with this report saying they're the favorite, we know what the model is in the modern NFL when you have a young quarterback that you believe in. Spin now. Take advantage of the fact that Darnold is underpaid if he's a real player. Surround him with talent. We've seen the Jets sign two wide receivers. We just talked about how the Jets signed Anthony Barr and C.J. Mosley to try to buttress the defense. They do need playmakers on that offensive side of the ball. They need difference makers. They need guys that aren't just, okay, he can have a big game, but guys you rely on. That's why the Jets, I think, will target Le'Veon Bell, even though they've spent a bunch of money already. It makes sense because they have the big bargain on their quarterback. The Texans are in that exact same spot with a bargain on the quarterback. I would also argue, if you're a running back, tell me if you disagree, you'd rather play in the AFC South than the AFC East. You'd rather play eight games in a dome as you would in Indy or Houston, plus the three road games in your division in good weather and good circumstances than the AFC East playing in New York and playing in that division. Maybe you think for the running back that's not as big of a concern as a wide receiver or a quarterback. When he has receiving is a big part of his game, and the...
I think the team and the franchise and your ability to try to win at a high level outweighs, am I going to be in the South or am I going to be in the AFC East? Being in the East, you know New England's in the East. So you know, man, what are my chances of winning the Super Bowl? How far are the Jets away? Those are the things he'd have to calculate.
And there will not be a more fresh quarterback, as far as his legs go, than Le'Veon Bell coming in this year since he took the year off. All right, we'll take a break. Coming up, will the Super Bowl champion Patriots, speaking of which, take a step back after yesterday? Next on First Things.